I welcome you all to the next session, residues. What is a residue? What's the literal meaning of residue? Residue means nothing but a small amount that is left behind. After the main part has gone, everything will be taken away, only a small part will be left over. That is called as a residue. In Tamil, we used to call it as mitcham. Okay. So what we are going to learn is what is this, how this residue will be related to complex function. That's what we are going to see now. You consider this function f of z, which is 1 by z into z minus 1. It has two singular points, 0 and 1. Now let me expand this f of z about z equal to 0 first. Then let me expand f of z about z equal to 1. Then let me try to integrate and see what happens. So expansion of f of z about z equal to 0 is minus 1 by z plus 1 plus z plus etc. Now let me integrate both sides over c. Let me take c as a circle. Now in this case, any closed curve otherwise. So if I integrate with respect to a closed curve, each and every term becomes integral over c minus 1 by z dz plus 1 integral over c 1 into dz plus integral over c z into dz plus etc. Now, my integrand here, this is not analytic about z equal to 0. But here the integrand is 1, it is analytic. F of z equal to 1 is analytic throughout the c. Z is also analytic. What will be the next term? Z square. Z square will be analytic. Z cube, everything, all the rest of the terms, remaining terms will be analytic. So whenever a function is analytic inside and on C, then according to Cauchy's theorem, the integral value will be 0. So these integrals becomes 0. Now I will be left with one and only integral. Integral over C minus 1 by Z dz. Since this integrand is not analytic at a point z equal to 0, which lies inside C, then according to Cauchy's integral formula, the value of the integral will be 2 pi I, this minus 1 into f of 0, according to Cauchy's integral formula. What is f of z? It is 1. So what will be f of 0 then? That is also 1. So minus 2 pi I into 1 will be minus 2 pi I. Let me expand the same function now about z equal to 1. So z minus 1 into z, so I am adding and subtracting 1. This z minus 1, since I am going to expand about z equal to 1, each and every factor should be of the form z minus 1. Now already this is of the form z minus 1. So I am trying to convert the second factor z as z minus 1, so I am adding and subtracting 1. 1 plus z minus 1 is taken to the numerator. Now this is of the form 1 plus x whole to the power minus 1. And expanding this, I will be getting 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 plus z minus 1 minus etc. Then once again integrating both sides over c with respect to z, we will be getting integral over c 1 by z minus 1 dz minus 1 into dz integral over c z minus 1 into dz etc. Now all the integrands after the first term are all analytic, therefore the integral value becomes 0. Now once again we will be left with the integral which is having the integrand as the form, as in the form 1 by z minus a. Now according to Cauchy's integral formula, this will be equal to 2 pi I into f of 1. What is f of z? F of z is 1. Therefore, f of 1 will also be 1. So, 2 pi a into 1 equal to 2 pi a. Now, let me show one more example. F of z is z square plus 2 by z minus 1 into z minus 2 the whole square. Now, this function is not analytic at z equal to 1 and 2. They are called as singular points. Actually, they are isolated singularities. Now, I want to expand this one as a Lorentz series. So, I am doing partial fraction. So this becomes 3 by z minus 1 minus 2 by z minus 2 plus 6 by z minus 2 the whole square. Now let me try to expand this function f of z after partial fraction about the point z equal to 1 first. Then let me try to expand as a Lorentz series about z equal to 2. Now let me do for z equal to 1. Now this one already is of the form z minus 1. So you keep this first term as it is and try to expand these two as a Lorentz series. Now z minus 2 is changed as z minus 1, just splitting this minus 2 as minus 1 minus 1. So this z minus 1, this minus is taken out, so minus into minus becomes plus, so it becomes 1 minus of z minus 1. That will be taken to the numerator, whole power minus 1. So 1 minus x whole power minus 1 is 1 plus z minus 1 plus z minus 1 the whole square plus etc. Similarly, the second term also in the same way, I am splitting this minus 2 as minus 1 minus 1, but here the power is 2, so it will become whole power minus 2. The expansion becomes 1 plus 2 into z minus 1 plus 3 into z minus 1 the whole square plus etc. Now integrating both sides over c with respect to z, now this becomes 3 into integral over c 1 by z minus 1 dz plus integral over c 2 into dz plus integral over c 2 times z minus 1 dz plus etc. plus 6 integral over c 6 dz plus 6 into 12 z minus 1 dz integral over c plus etc. Now all the integrand are all analytic, therefore the value of all these integral becomes 0. Now once again I will be left with the one and only integral, which is of the form 1 by z minus a. Now 3 into this becomes 2 pi I into f of 1 according to Cauchy's integral formula. So it becomes 6 pi I. Now let us expand this f of z about the point z equal to 2. Now look at the denominators. They are the factors of z equal to 2. So you keep these two as it is and try to make this z minus 1 in the form of z minus 2. So you add and subtract 1, so it becomes z minus 2, 1 plus z minus 2, take to the numerator, it becomes whole power minus 1, copy the remaining as it is, expand this, it becomes 1 minus z minus 2 plus z minus 2 the whole square plus etc. Now integrating both sides, once again if I integrate each and every term, look at the terms, all these terms are analytic. So according to Cauchy's formula, everything becomes 0. The last two terms, they are not analytic about z equal to 2, at the point z equal to 2. So, I am going to make use of Cauchy's integral formula for the first integral. And for this one, I am going to use Cauchy's integral formula for derivatives, higher derivatives. So, minus 2, 2 pi I into f of 2, where f of z is 1. So, f of 2 will become 1. Here, this is 6 into 2 pi I by 1 factorial, f dashed of 2, what is f of z? 1, f dashed of z? 0, f dashed of 2 is also 0, so this term becomes 0, so I will be left with minus 4 pi. So this value is contributed by the integral, which is of the form integral 1 by z minus a dz. So looking at all the expansions, what is the similarity between all the expansions? You get the non-zero answer only for the integral which is of the form 1 by z minus a dz. Here also you got the non-zero answer only for this one. So all the terms becomes 0 except the integral which is having the which has the format 1 by z minus a, integral having the format 1 by z minus a. Now so what's the conclusion? Whenever you expand a function as a Lorentz series about its singular points and if you integrate, you will be the value of the integral will be contributed by the term containing, otherwise contributed by the integral having integrand in the format of 1 by z minus a, and everything becomes 0. So this will be the only leftover quantity. That's why it is called as residue. This is called as residue. Now, the main concept, let me come into the definition of a residue. What is a residue then for a function f of z? A is an isolated singularity, means then if I find residue of f of z at the point A, that will be nothing but coefficient of 1 by z minus a in the Lorentz series expansion of f of z about a. What is Lorentz series actually? Lorentz series expansion is in f of z equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a n into z minus a whole power n plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity b n by z minus a whole power n. This is the terms with the positive powers, and this expansion contains terms with the negative powers of z minus a, and this is called as principal part. So what is b1? B1 is the first term of your principal part, that is when you put bn equal to 1, it is. So whenever you collect the coefficient of 1 by z minus a in Lorentz series expansion, coefficient of 1 by z minus a is b1. This b1, according to Lorentz theorem, what's the formula for bn? 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a whole power minus n plus 1 dz. When you substitute n equal to 1, it becomes 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z dz by z minus a whole power 0, which is 1. So integral over c f of z dz. So residue of f of z about the point a is, it is coefficient of 1 by z minus a in the Lorentz series expansion about z equal to a. Otherwise, this coefficient of z minus a can be rewritten as b1 of the principal b1. Coefficient of z minus a in the principal part is b1. What is b1? b1 is 1 by 2 pi a integral over c f of z dz. One more common thing I want to mention here. We came to know that while we integrate both sides with respect to z over c, we will be left with the integral which is having integrant of the format 1 by z minus a. Now, looking at the final answer, you omit this 2 pi I. What is the constant multiplied with the 2 pi I? Minus 1. Now, coming to the expansion, what is the principal part here? This is the only principal part. All of them are positive powers. So this is the only principal part. What is the first? This is of the form 1 by z minus 0 whole power 1. So what is b1 here? b1 is minus 1. So what they explained, what they defined about residue? Residue is nothing but coefficient of 1 by z minus a in Lorentz series, where a is the isolated singularity. Here 0 is the isolated singularity. So what is coefficient of z minus 0? Minus 1. That is multiplied with the 2 pi I. About z equal to 1, what is the coefficient of 1 by z minus 1? 1. So 2 pi I multiplied with 1. Coming to the next example, we are expanding about z equal to 1, so I have to find the coefficient of 1 by z minus 1. What is coefficient of 1 by z minus 1? It is 3. So the final answer will be multiplied with 3 into 2 pi I. Here also, this is the expansion about z equal to 2. So I need the coefficient of 1 by z minus 2. Where is 1 by z minus 2? What is its coefficient? Minus 2. So look at the answer, 2 pi I is multiplied with the minus 2, so we are getting minus 4 pi I. So the value of the integral depends on the 2 pi I, omit the 2 pi I, multiplied with residue. What is residue? Coefficient of 1 by z minus a. So residue of a function at the point A. Whenever we want to integrate a function which is having isolated singularities, then I need the residue. Residue is multiplied with the 2 pi I. So we are very much concerned about the residue. The value of the integral depends on the residue. So we are going to learn methods of finding residues. Already we know that how to find a residue. The residue is nothing but coefficient of 1 by z minus a in Lorentz series. So you can expand your function f of z about z equal to a, and you can find the coefficient of 1 by z minus a, so that you will get residue. There are some more methods. Without Lorentz series we can also find residue, but the thing is you can find residues only for poles using those methods. There are four methods here. These four methods can be used to find the residues only for poles, not for essential singularity. What about removable singularity? Removable singularity means the principal part, there won't be any principal part, so automatically residue will be zero. So we are going to discuss residues only for poles and essential singularity. Whenever it is a pole, you can make use of these four methods, or you can go with Lorentz series. But when it is essential singularity, if you want to find a residue, no other go, you have to use only Lorentz series. Okay. So let me teach you the methods of finding residue when your pole is a, when your singularity is a pole. The first three methods dealt with simple poles. These three methods can be utilized for simple poles. And the last method is for pole of order m, which is greater than 1. Okay, if z equal to a is a simple pole, the formula for residue of f of z at the point a is equal to limit z turns to a multiplied with the factor of z equal to a and the original function. Automatically this z minus a, which is in the denominator of f of z, will get cancelled, and then you apply the limit and find the residue. Method 2, something similar to method 1. So simple. Here the restriction is f of z equal to g of z by z minus a. Already when z equal to a is a simple pole means f of z should contain its denominator as z minus a. That's why it becomes a pole. So here deliberately they are writing f of z as g of z by z minus a. So omitting this factor, they are taking g of z and finding limit at the point z equal to a, which is nothing but g of a. Both of them are same. Here what we are doing, we are multiplying z minus a with f of z. This f of z contains z minus a as one of the factors in the denominator. So those two will get cancelled. After that you have to apply the limit. Here, after, just remove that z minus a and take the g of z and apply the limit. Both of them are same, represented in different way. Method 3, whenever it is a pole, simple pole a, when your f of z is of the form h of z by k of z, where k of a equal to 0, that means a is a pole, that's why the denominator getting 0 means then that a is a pole, that's why it's a pole. And the numerator h of a is not equal to 0. In such case, the residue can be calculated using the formula h of a by k dash of a. Whenever it is a simple pole of order m, then the residue is will be equal to m minus 1th derivative of g at the point a. You differentiate f of g of z m minus 1 times and substitute z equal to a divided by m minus 1 factorial. So this is the formula for finding residue of a pole A of order m, which is greater than 1. With this, we came to know about the, what is a residue, the importance of residue. Only residue contributes to the value of the integral. And we have defined what is a residue, and we have learned the methods of finding residue when they are poles. The next session we will see problems on residues.